Imagine bringing the power of After Effects animations into Premiere Pro. One template file that has so much options that you can create your own custom motion graphics right inside Adobe Premiere Pro with just one click of a button. Well, we call that the super title. Videoblocks is an organized stock website with tons of clips, designs, and music. It distinguishes itself from other stock websites by its premium quality for affordable prices. Plus, whatever you buy and download will be forever yours. No extra licenses needed. Visit videoblocks.com/cinecom. More information in the description below. What's up, guys? Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and I'm again super excited. This time it's because we are introducing this super title. Now, since the latest update of Adobe Premiere Pro CC 2017, you are able to import motion graphics templates that are actually created inside After Effects. So that means you can bring the functionality from After Effects into Premiere Pro and change some of the options, like the color usually, with just a click of a button. Now, in a previous video, we have created 10 lower thirds templates. You can find the link to it in the description below. They are free to download, and you're able to change things like the color and, of course, the source text. But we had tons of reactions on those templates, like how can I change the font and how can I change this, etc. And unfortunately, all of those things were not so practical, because you need to set up those templates inside After Effects, and it's actually still pretty limited to what you can change. But those questions did start to make me think about this idea of having a super title, and that is this thing that you're looking at right now. These are not different templates that you're seeing here. This is just one same template, and you can change everything that you want in here. So you can change the font, as you can see, which was definitely not easy to bring that option into Premiere. We actually had to do some coding there inside After Effects, write these expressions with JavaScript. So the nerd inside me had some real fun this weekend. And also things like the animations, because you can see that the animations are not the same over these different clips. So let's have a look, guys, how we can install this inside Premiere first and then go through the options. You want to make sure that you have the Essential Graphics panel here open. If you can't see it, go over to Window here on top and select Essential Graphics. That will open up this window. Then the next thing that you have to do is go to Browse here on this tab, and you want to click here on the Install Motion Graphics Template icon. Click on that and just locate the file that you can download for free, by the way, from our website. There's a link in the description below, right here, super title. And we actually have two versions here. We've got the motion blur version and the one without. Reasons for it being is that the motion blur template file is pretty heavy. So if your computer has trouble with this one, then you can just use the normal super title file. So let's click here on this one, double click on that, and it will install that into the motion graphics or the essential graphics panel right here. Super title 1.0. And we'll get to that in just a minute, why it's called the 1.0. So let's drag that into the timeline like so. It will load itself in. And right here, this is what you'll see. Super title. If you select that layer and head over to the Edit tab here on top, you will see all the controls. Let's go quickly over these controls because they are pretty straightforward. First of all, you can change the text to anything you'd like. Next, you can change the font size, which was requested previously. So now you have that option. Then we have the font selector, and this is also pretty cool. I have loaded in 5 fonts. Unfortunately, we can't load in the fonts from your computer. So what I had to do is some sort of pre-create these fonts and then kind of link that to this slider, which you can see right here. And I've chosen to go for 5 fonts that are default on any computer. But the idea is to add tons of more fonts to this template, and that's why it's called the 1.0, guys. This is more of a beta version and more of a test. I want to see how this idea evolves. And what I want you guys to do is leave in the comments below which kind of idea you have that should be added to this super title. And what we want to go to in version 2.0 or 3.0 somewhere is a super title that has just so much options that you can really create some unique animations inside Premiere Pro with just a few clicks. Because that's the only thing that you have to do in here. Just click these check boxes and you're changing the animation. So first of all, we have the text animations, and currently we only have incoming animations, but again, the idea is to add more also outgoing animations as well. So you can choose to let the text come in from the left if you enable that option here, and just let's have a look. It's coming in from the left. There we go. And you can also change that to something else. For example, you want it to zoom, then you also have that now. So now the text is zooming in. So here you have like 5 basic incoming animations. And now comes a pretty cool thing. You can add some extra movement to that animation. For example, you can enable the bounce effect, and let's just play that and see how that looks. So now it will zoom in, but also kind of bounce a little bit. And this applies also to the other animations, by the way. You can also say that it has to rotate if you want so. Like that. And you can choose to enable the 3D text, and that will kind of make these letters here turn into a 3D space, as you can see right here. But again, you can choose to enable that or disable that, and that's a pretty cool thing about this super title. This way, you can just really create your own unique style. The next thing that we have is the background. Here, you can have different kinds of animations, like a background solid color. Should that slide up? Should that slide open? Or should that circle in? Like here, this example. This is pretty cool in combination with the rotation here as well, having something like this. And of course, underneath the background option, you can change the color of that background, for example, to yellow, if you like that more. And now the text isn't so visible anymore, so I'm going to scroll back up and enable the text shadow with just one click of a button. And let's change the font as well to impact and perhaps increase the size a bit more of that so that it's more prominent in the shot. Look how easy this all is. And if you want to draw some more attention towards the title, then you can enable the vignetting as well. Just click on that and now we'll see that we have this very smooth vignetting here going on in the corners. You can also enable a secondary background, and this is something pretty cool as well. When the animation is coming in, you can have like this extra color to it. So first the red, so this is actually the secondary animation of the background coming in, and then we have the primary animation here. And again, also of that, you can change the color here down below. So this is what we have at the current time, guys. It's more of a test to see where this could go. It's still in big development, but I want you guys to just try it out and leave me any feedback in the comments below. What should be added? Is there something not working? Let me know down below, guys. Also, we have no plans at this point to ever ask money for this title. I believe it's just so cool that everyone should have access to it. So we'll keep on developing on this title. Make sure also to just spread this message around so that everyone can enjoy this awesome idea of having a super title inside Adobe Premiere Pro. So guys, just head over to the download page from the link right here. And there's also a sign-up form to our newsletter if you would like to stay updated if there's going to be a new version of this super title in the future. Because we're not going to make a new video every time that there's a small update. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, stay creative.